Today we've actually done sand mistakes before, but this time specific to CaribSea. So we've made mistakes using CaribSea sand before,
yes.
So you don't have to. All right, so starting with number one, if you've ever considered black sand before, like me, you should actually know this one up front.
Yeah, so don't make the mistake of not realizing that black sand and some of the particles in it are magnetic, which means on your cleaner.
Yeah, on your cleaner means scratch glass.
Ooh.
So if you bring your magnetic cleaner down to do the sand and it gets little bits of magnetic sand in there, you can scratch your glass. So make sure that if you use black sand that you're thinking about how I'm gonna clean the sand and pay attention to your magnetic cleaner that it isn't picking up little particles that will scratch your glass. Number two, black isn't always black.
Yeah, so after a while when you've got coralline algae, remember that black sand will eventually turn purple in some places.
Yeah, it really depends on the amount of flow that you have, but keep in mind specifically with the bigger chunks of black sand, because there are larger particle sizes of black sand out there. If they're not turning over all the time, they actually turn purple from coralline algae. Number three, on a macro photo, it looks really cool.
Yeah, so the mistake is thinking that Fiji pink is easy to see pink and vibrant pink when actually it's a few particles in there that are actually pink.
Yeah, so it sounds really cool, Fiji pink.
Yeah.
But really what it is sifted out sand and they added some I believe it's like rose quartz to it. So you have to really look really close though to be able to see it. So make sure that's the right particle size for you and don't let the little bits of rose quartz attract you too much. All right, so that leads to number four and a pretty direct recommendation.
The mistake is missing that special grade CaribSea is the number one sand that we've seen, we've used, and that a lot of you reefers are using.
Yeah, there's two spectrums here. There's super fine that looks the nicest, but blows all over the place, and you're constantly moving around. Mm-hmm. And then there's very large,
yes,
which captures all kinds of detritus and waste, and generally just doesn't look very good. And right in the middle is special grade, and why it's the most popular, as voted by you guys, and what you guys are actually buying, and what we use here, special grade. If you're actually looking for one specific recommendation, special grade is it. Number five, we talk about live sand a lot, but there's another option.
Yeah, the mistake is missing the value of dry sand. This is a 40-pound bag of dry sand. It's the same special grade, but it comes at a significantly less cost.
Yeah, the less cost is because you're not paying for water weight.
Yeah.
So if you don't care about the live aspect of the sand and you're going to populate your tank with bacteria on your own, well, then you know what? Dry sand is actually a better value, including some other sands like this one, which is actually pseudo-dry,
yeah,
just moist. In relation to that, if you do use live sand, there is an important factor here.
Yeah, don't make the mistake of not using the water and the water in the bag where most of the bacteria are, and we've mentioned this one in our sand fails.
Yeah, so in the case of the live sand, actually what live sand is dried, sifted sand to get the right particles that you want. Mm-hmm. Then they add the water and they add a dormant bacteria to the water. So it's the water that actually has the bacteria in it. So if you pour the water out, you're pouring all the bacteria out with it. So if you do value live sand, make sure that you use the water. It's the important part. Number seven, I want the nice look, but my sand blows around. Is there a hybrid method?
The mistake is mixing the sands. So not a hybrid method because the lighter particle sand will go one way, the heavier particle sand will stay or go another way.
Yeah, so you can do it.
Yeah.
The answer is, but you can't mix them up and assume that they won't get unmixed. So what will happen is right where the two pumps intersect and you're blowing all the fine sand away, all the large particles will stay put. It'll look totally different though. There'll be a bunch of large particle sand in the center,
yeah,
and fine sand on the outside. That might be better than that what you had before, but at least know what you're going into. They won't stay mixed, they actually separate. Number eight, I actually just covered this a little bit,
yeah,
and it's knowing what you're getting into.
Yeah, the mistake is not understanding what live sand is, and just like Ryan said, the bacteria are in the water.
Yeah, so that's actually a really big question people ask all the time, like the value of live sand and how fast it helps you cycle your tank. I don't have the answer for that.
Right.
But I will tell you that make sure you know what you're getting into. It isn't live sand. In this case, from the ocean, there are options like that.
Yeah.
But most of the CaribSea just live sand is actually just dried sifted sand where they added bacteria and water. It's kind of like a bacterial additive and sand all in one. Number nine, there's an upside and a downside to this, so I'm gonna tell you both.
Yeah, so don't make the mistake of not understanding what the ocean direct sand is. It's not the live sand with water in it, it's something different.
Yeah, so pick what speaks to you, but go into it knowing what you're doing. So in the past, I've used the ocean direct sand because of the specific factor. It doesn't have all that water weight in the bag. It's shipped just moist, which means that it actually has bacteria from the ocean here. It has a breathable bag to keep it alive. Mm. And I like that aspect of this sand. However, note, because it is moist and not dry, it's never been sifted, which means it has a wider range of particle sizes in it, and you'll definitely see that in your tank. And that separation that we've seen in a high flow tank can happen. So just be aware that it's not as uniform a size, but you have those natural bacteria benefits. All right, so number 10. This is actually one I'm gonna say a lot, I think, in some of these fails videos.
Yeah, the mistake here is not watching a BRStv Investigates video that I did on sand. There's some differences between dry, there's some differences between live, and how much sand you actually get.
If you wanna know how much sand to get, not based on a calculator, but based on some actual data, you're gonna find it right here.